students, I am here to explain to you here about a sixth chapter, that is our constitution. As our constitution, you were having a doubt that what is constitution? It is nothing but a set of rules and regulations made for people of our country. Here, students are going to explain about constitution, the sets of rules of rules and regulations formed in our country, how it has been formed, and when, what is the importance of that, and features of our constitution. Why we have constitution? Students, can you answer me why we have constitution? It is to run our government in a proper way, in a peaceful manner. For example, if we have school. Behind our school, we have rules and regulations. Why we have schools? Rules and regulations to maintain peacefully and silently our school in a manner. That's why to run a country in a proper and good manner, our constitution came into existence. When our constitution came into existence? After independence. Here, I will explain you step by step what is the importance and meaning, salient features of our constitution. Here, students, as I told you that a set of rules and regulations formed for our country is known as constitution. Here, every citizen should follow the constitution. Here, no one is poor, no one is rich, no one cares. If we can say that they are of rich people, they can, they should not follow, it is not like that. For example, if we are all students are in school, teachers see all that they all students are equally like that. And all are equal in front of their eyes. Here no one is rich, no one is poor. If he is prime minister also, president also, every man, every person, every individual should follow the rules and regulations of our constitutions. If they are not following their constitutions, rules and regulations, they are going to be punished. Here the constitution is a reference guide to the government. What is constitution here? It is a reference guide. For example, it guides the government. People's government is nothing but public. It guides the public to how to run or how to be the government. How should we have to live our life? What our rights? In our constitution, not we have only rights, but we have duties also. As we are living in, for example, if we are living in a school, that only we should follow the rules and regulations. So, we have other things also, except that we have other things to be followed. For example, if we are living in our house, what are the features? What should have to be followed? To maintain our house clean, healthy. For maintaining healthy, it is nothing but that only. For running our constitution in a proper manner, for it is the rights and duties of every person to follow the constitution, to respect our Indian constitution. Here, I will not say the meaning of constitution next year. Next point is importance of constitution. So next year, in front of constitution, as I said you that president is no one is here. In front of high, no one are rich, no one are poor, no one is high, no one is low. So here, for example, parliamentary members or president, prime minister, they all should follow the rules and regulations. They are bound, the judges and officers are bound by it. The parliamentaries are bound by it. So they have to follow the rules and regulations. Here, important is it protects the rights of citizens and all are equal before the law. Just as I said you that in front of constitution, all are equal. In function, it functions as a reference guide to the duties to be performed by the government. It is the rights, it is the duty of every person, every individual to follow the rules and regulations of our constitution. Next, it coordinates the functions of the democratic institutions such as legislature, executive and judiciary. Here, these are three organs of government. Here, listen here, students. These are the three main organs of government. The organs are legislative, executive and judiciary. Here, what is legislature? Legislature is nothing but a group of persons also makes the law. Here, next, executive, a group of committee that implement the laws. India. Then here after this students, I would like to tell you about when our constitution came into force and its existence. Now students, now I would like to tell you about the constitution when it has been adopted and it has been came into existence by when it has been approved. Here our constitution was adopted on January 26, 1950. Have you remembered so students? 26th of Jan, we celebrate this day every year as Republic Day. Here, it declares that India as a republic. Our constitution, what it declares? It declares that our constitution is a republic. It is a form of government. How it is a form of government? In other countries, we can see students, they are leaders are elected by their own, or it is monarchy type of government. Monarchy, there is nothing but king or queen is ruling there. But in our India, it is a form of independent country, republic country, democratic form of government. Means here, the people elect their representative, their own elected or their own leader by giving vote. By giving vote, they used to select their own representative, own leader. That is nothing but republic form of government, democratic form of government. That we are electing our own leader by giving vote. By majority of people, if they given a vote to a same member, that member is going to be a known as leader. Now we have said it declares India as a republic. Who declares India as a republic? It declares our constitution. And the constitution was adopted on 26th of January 1950. Then post general election held between 1951 to 1952. The post general election has been held on 1951 to 1952. And what happened students? Our constitution was approved on earlier notice. On which date? On 26th of November 1949, the constitution was approved. It was approved by Constituent Assembly. It was checked by Constituent Assembly because there were elder leaders. So after approving our constitution, it has been came into existence on 26th of January 1950. For remarking days, we used to celebrate 26th January, a memorable day as Republic Day. Next year, because it has been approved on 26th of November, that's why this day is on every year, this day is celebrated in the government offices as Constitution Day. Here, student, our government is our constitution is a parliamentary form of government. It has been taken from a country, America. This has been taken from that America, to be said. With bicameral legislation. Here two houses are there in parliament, that is Lok Sabha and Rajya Sabha. That is here it is nothing but a small class Sabha and Rajya Sabha is elder. Lok Sabha and Rajya Sabha. If something has been not formed in Lok Sabha, then it has been, the bill will be passed to the Rajya Sabha. And it has been Lok Sabha and Rajya Sabha has been came into force in 1952. Next, our size of our constitution, students. Our constitution, it contains 395 articles and 12 schedules in our constitution book. Next, students, I would like to explain you about preamble to the constitution. Preamble to the constitution is the introducing part of our constitution. You are getting a little confusing, students. Constitution is set up with rules and regulations. It is a set of rules and regulations. It is a book. Because our constitution is a written form that has been ruled by drafting committee. I said to you that member drafting committee's chairman was Dr. P.R. Ambedkar. Now let us see about the introducing part. Republic.
Not by doing fighting or doing fights,
no rules and regulation has been different from central or state. That only one role is there for all. That means central. In what the rules has been implemented in central only, then we have to follow in state also. Next is republic. Here, it is a form of people government where people can elect their own representative. Here, it is a form of republic. Next, fundamental rights and duties. In our constitution, students, we have six fundamental rights. Six fundamental rights and 11 duties. Fundamental duties. That should we should follow fundamental rights and duties. Here we have the rights. Then, for example, we should think like that if our country is our home. And many of them doesn't have thinking, the thing, and they used to protect our fundamental rights and duties. We should respect our constitution and whatever national emblem, national things, whatever are there, we should respect them. And we should follow the we have fundamental rights, that is 6, and fundamental duties 11. Next, secularism. Here, students, our constitution, we have secularism also. Here, we can follow any religion, any on which we have faith. There is no restrictions for not to follow these or that. There is no any force for citizens to follow that religion or their religion. We have our own kind of faith. We can worship any god. Next is independent judiciary. Here I said the Supreme Court is the judiciary. It is one of the organs of government. Here judiciary is nothing but law interpretation. Here they have rights. If any member or any citizen is not following the proper rules and regulations, if they saw anything wrong, but the people of citizen of India, they have right, they are independent, they can punish. No one can interfere in their matter. Next, they can give any punishment if they saw anything wrong by the people, those who are not following any rules or those who are going against of any rules and regulations of our constitution. Next, universal adult franchise. Here, students, we have a right to vote. After the years of 18, every member has eligible to vote. It is nothing but universal adult franchise. By voting means to whom we are voting. Here, we have right to vote our own representative by seeing those who are, by seeing whether their government, which government can be helpful for us, which government is good for our constitutions to be offered for our area, those who can run our government. Here, I begin with this election system. For years, students, here our constitution fixes of our constitution election system is also there. This one I said about universal government franchise. After the years of 18, we have eligible, we are eligible to vote. The election system is nothing but we are voting our own representative. And every 5 years, we used to do election for prime minister, for every minister. For example, students, why we have constitution? If constitution is there, why we have MLAs, PMs, CM? New question may be arises. Only one can run, but it is not like that. One individual cannot manage it. For example, if we are running a school, to run it properly, here and management only also there, principal also there, teachers are also there. Because management cannot handle the whole school. The person cannot understand the problems of students, whether the students are getting or not getting. She can't handle the whole class or all the classes, okay? Cannot explain. That's why to learn this skill systematically, to educate, to give knowledge every person, every individual student, to run it properly, it has been given our rules and regulations for schools to be followed. I think our constitution is also like that, to look out for every citizen individually, to look whether they are interested, whether they are happy with the constitution or not. It has been set up in every state level is CM is there, for central level PM is there, for area wise corporate there is also like that, look for every individual. So thank you, students. All things I have explained about is our constitution.